Hi guys, welcome to the 5th and 6th episodes recap of the K-drama The World of the Married. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to it. Yeon-woo is still waiting for Jae-hyuk, notices Sun-woo arriving home at dawn. Tae-oh too wakes up to find Sun-woo not in bed. When he goes to check, he finds her sleeping on the sofa. So Tae-oh goes through her phone and finds a receipt for a hotel. Sun-woo, who is pretending to be asleep, sees Tae-oh checking her phone. The next morning, Sun-woo notices Tae-oh struggling to talk to her. He manages to ask her at what time she got home. Sun-woo tells him that she arrived at dawn and rented a room at a hotel with her colleagues to have a drink. Once Sun-woo leaves with Jun-young, Tae-oh makes a call to the hotel to check. At the hospital, Ji-chol introduces Sun-woo to their newest psychiatrist, Dr. Kim Yoon-gi. Tae-oh makes a call to Myung-suk to check if Sun-woo is at work. As they talk, Myung-suk brings up the flower basket thinking Tae-oh sent it, which surprises him. Later, Sun-woo meets with Jae-hyuk to learn about Tae-oh's company. He informs her that Tae-oh hasn't paid the rent for several months and didn't pay the salary to his staff last month. When asked about Tae-oh's personal accounts, Jae-hyuk informs her that he has done everything he can for her under a legal frame. If he's to access the personal accounts, he should get something in return. As Sun-woo leaves declining his offer, Jae-hyuk informs her that he will be waiting for her in the same hotel the next day. As Sun-woo leaves, she drives past Yeon-woo, who is on her way to Jae-hyuk. Both women spot each other as they drive past them. Jae-hyuk is shocked to see Yeon-woo, who has brought him clean clothes, since she was told that he is working overnight. Yeon-woo retorts to him that he seems comfortable even though he told her that he was busy. She then tells him that she wants kids and demands him to cooperate. Before he could refuse, Yeon-woo leaves the office. At home, when Sun-woo gets a text while she is in the bathroom, Tae-oh decides to check, but Sun-woo has set up a password. When he struggles to replace the phone, he finds Sun-woo staring at him. So Tae-oh tells her that he was just looking at the phone, since he thought of buying him a new one, and quickly leaves. Apparently, the text is from Jae-hyuk, informing Sun-woo that he has the details on Tae-oh's account ready. The next day, Yoon-ki crosses into Sun-woo as she heads to the hospital. Yoon-ki comments about Sun-woo looking as if she didn't get enough sleep, and suggests that she needs to stop being a perfectionist in order to live a happy life. Sun-woo silently walks away. Myung-suk notices Yoon-ki following after Sun-woo as he calls out for her. Yoon-ki apologizes if he offended Sun-woo, saying he was only trying to take care of the staff's mental health as well. Sun-woo accepts his apology and goes to her room. Sun-woo gets a call from Yeon-woo asking for a meeting. Yeon-woo confesses to her that she wants to have children, but Jae-hyuk is not cooperating. Sun-woo explains to her that it is not her expertise and recommends receiving couple consultations. Sun-woo then brings up about driving past Yeon-woo the other day and asks her if she is not curious why she went to see Jae-hyuk. Yeon-woo tells her that Jae-hyuk is a good financial consultant anyway and quickly leaves. Sun-woo then gets a text from Jae-hyuk asking her to meet him at night. In-Gyu, on the other hand, goes through Hyun-seo's cupboards looking for food. He finds Hyun-seo's pills in one of the cupboards. Just then Hyun-seo gets home. In-Gyu realizes that Hyun-seo has been helping Sun-woo in return for the pills. Sun-woo goes to a hotel to meet her attorney and runs into Hae-joon on her way. When Sun-woo greets her and tries to leave, Hae-joon calls out for her and invites her and Tae-oh for a dinner. Sun-woo accepts the invitation. Sun-woo confessed to her attorney that Tae-oh is starting to get suspicious of her, and he's even trying to unlock her phone. The attorney advises her to try to put up for at least 2 to 3 weeks. Jae-hyuk, on the other hand, waits for Sun-woo in the hotel they last met, but Sun-woo doesn't show up. Because he is unable to reach her on the phone, Jae-hyuk decides to go to her house. When Sun-woo gets home, she finds Jae-hyuk with Tae-oh. Tae-oh gets a call and goes to answer. While alone with Sun-woo, Jae-hyuk tells her that he waited for her in the hotel. He assumes that Tae-oh is unaware that Sun-woo is going to divorce him. He also adds that Tae-oh has $320,000 in total in his slush fund account. Jae-hyuk urges her to get his help without going to a lawyer, since she might have to divide the money with Tae-oh if she goes to a lawyer, but Jae-hyuk can make sure Sun-woo gets all the money. The next day, Dong-sik visits Sun-woo and comments that she probably wants to kill her husband, since just getting a divorce would not do him justice. He urged her to just say the word, and he would take care of it for her. Sun-woo tries to explain to him that she would take care of it, since it is a personal matter. Dong-sik gets aggressive on hearing it, demanding to know why she's turning down his goodwill. He becomes violent and starts smashing things, and Sun-woo gets injured as well. Yoon-ki rushes to Sun-woo's aid and takes Dong-sik off her. Sun-woo goes into a shock, and Yoon-ki holds her as she gets a panic attack. After things settle down, Sun-woo explains to Yoon-ki that Dong-sik was a patient of hers for over a year. She has recommended him to see a psychiatrist, since he seems to suffer from obsessive-compulsive disorder, but he has refused it. Yoon-ki observes Sun-woo as she talks, and asks her if this is the first time she got a panic attack, and wonders if she ever suffered from a post-traumatic disorder which she never got treated for. As she prepares to leave the hospital, Sun-woo remembers a car accident. In-Gyu scares her by jumping onto the windshield, saying he needs to talk to her. In-Gyu brings up the pill she prescribed for Hyun-seo in order to tail her husband. He demands her to hand him the money, or else he'll expose her, which would cancel her medical license. Jun-young waits for Sun-woo to pick him up from the academy. Because she doesn't show up, Jun-young makes a call to Tae-oh and informs him that Sun-woo is not picking up the phone. So Tae-oh goes to pick up Jun-young. He takes Jun-young to a restaurant to have a meal. In there, Da-kyung runs into them. Jun-young remarks that he hates people like Da-kyung when Tae-oh continues to stare at her, so Da-kyung leaves the restaurant. To Jun-young's disappointment, Tae-oh excuses himself to use the bathroom and goes after Da-kyung. Once they got home, Tae-oh makes a call to Myung-suk to know at what time Sun-woo left the hospital. After the call, Jun-young comes to him asking if Sun-woo is angry because Tae-oh did something wrong. To Jun-young's frustration, Tae-oh insists that he didn't do anything wrong and would sort things out with Sun-woo. Sun-woo stops by a bar tent to have soju. As she leaves the tent, it starts to rain. Sun-woo tries to cross the road while it's at the red light. On seeing an oncoming car, Sun-woo remembers the accident that killed her parents while she was in high school. Geung-sok pulls her off the road before she gets into an accident. He then takes her to his house, and Sun-woo confesses everything to him. Geung-sok advises her to leave with Jun-young and start a new life. But Sun-woo tells him that she has nowhere to go, since she even doesn't have her parents, so she can't leave everything she built up. Geung-sok argues that it doesn't matter what others think, and advises her not to do anything further, or else she'd end up like him. Tae-oh, on the other hand, waits for Sun-woo. He goes to check when she gets home, and sees her crying, so Tae-oh heads back to the room leaving Sun-woo. The next day, as Hyun-seo leaves for work, In-Gyu warns her not to try anything with Sun-woo, since it's the only way for her to survive. Hyun-seo then runs into Da-kyung, who is packing up her stuff. She informs Hyun-seo that she broke up with her boyfriend and is moving back to her parents' house. She suggests Hyun-seo should do the same and not let her boyfriend control her. Hyun-seo meets with Sun-woo and apologizes for not hiding her pills properly. She also assumes that Sun-woo no longer wants her help, and asks for the money she promised. Hyun-seo also informs her that Da-kyung has broken up with Tae-oh, and even left the apartment. Sun-woo sends a text informing Jae-hyuk that she will come to the hotel at night. So Jae-hyuk tells her about Bong-koo deciding to be Tae-oh's investor. Sun-woo then takes Tae-oh to Bong-koo's house for dinner, without saying where they're going. On their way, Tae-oh asks Sun-woo about the flowers she received. Sun-woo casually tells him that Jae-hyuk sent them to her. When Tae-oh realizes that they are at Bong-koo's house, Tae-oh tries to stop her. So Sun-woo tells him that Hae-joon invited them for dinner. Hae-joon is surprised to see them, so Sun-woo reminds her that she invited them. Bong-koo also arrives to greet them, so when Sun-woo apologizes for coming, Bong-koo and Hae-joon invite them in. Sun-woo gets fascinated by seeing their house, so Hae-joon and Bong-koo encourage her to look around. Tae-oh tries to stop her when she starts going all over the house. Da-kyung, who is in her room, overhears Tae-oh's voice and comes out of her room to check, only to run into Sun-woo and Tae-oh. Sun-woo, on the other hand, picks up a vase, and on seeing Da-kyung, she intentionally drops it. At the dinner table, Sun-woo suggests toasting for Bong-koo being Tae-oh's investor. Bong-koo and Tae-oh is shocked to know that Sun-woo is aware of it, and Da-kyung too for not knowing about it at all. So she refuses to toast. Hae-joon remarks that Sun-woo seems a bit off her usual self, and asks her if she is having any problems. So Sun-woo tells her that Tae-oh is cheating on her. When Tae-oh tries to excuse themselves saying Sun-woo is under a lot of stress, Sun-woo brings up Da-kyung's pregnancy, and tells them that Da-kyung got pregnant while having an affair with her husband. Bong-koo and Hae-joon are shocked to hear it. Sun-woo retorts at Da-kyung for falling for a man like Tae-oh on seeing Tae-oh trying to hide it. When Bong-koo lashes out at Sun-woo for being rude to his daughter, Sun-woo points out that they should have taught their daughter well to not break anyone else's family. Da-kyung gets furious and beats up Sun-woo, but gets stopped by Bong-koo. Sun-woo then thanks for the dinner and leaves as everyone else is in shock. Jae-hyuk, on the other hand, happily enters the hotel room expecting to find Sun-woo. But to his shock, he finds Yeo-rim. Yeo-rim tearfully confesses to him that she already knew that he was spending nights with other women. Jae-hyuk casually explains to her that he felt no emotions for the women including Sun-woo, but only got physically engaged. Tae-oh goes after Sun-woo and demands to know why she did it. Sun-woo reminds him that she gave him plenty of chances to come clean. She then tells him that she wants a divorce and warns him not to come near Jun-young. Tae-oh yells at her that even though he was with another woman, he had no intentions to leave his family. Sun-woo then reveals to him that she slept with Jae-hyuk. Tae-oh is shocked to hear it and shout out at her that Jae-hyuk is his friend, so she shouldn't have done it. She admits that she wanted to get even with him, and tells him to hold on to whatever he is feeling right now, since that is exactly what she felt when he was with Da-kyung. When Tae-oh tells her that she has no right to take away Jun-young, Sun-woo tells him that Jun-young already witnesses him with Da-kyung. Mi-yeon and No-yul, on the other hand, stay with Jun-young at home. Mi-yeon tries to explain to him that divorce is not a bad thing. Without a word, Jun-young leaves the table, and as Mi-yeon tries to follow, Jun-young locks himself in his room. Mi-yeon explains to him that she is trying to explain things, not because of his mother, but because she feels sorry for Jun-young. Later, Da-kyung finds Tae-oh sitting on the side of the road smoking a cigarette. Da-kyung approaches him and asks him if he went out with her because of Bong-koo. but Tae-oh tells her that Bong-ku made his investment only because he saw Tae-oh's talent. Da-kyung asks him to put out the cigarette since it is bad for the baby. She tells her that she can give up everything including his parents, if Tae-oh decides to be with her. Yeom drives past Sun-woo as Sun-woo walks home. She scorns Sun-woo that she would not let her family be destroyed as Sun-woo wanted. But Sun-woo clarifies all she wanted to do was to make her feel what it is like to be betrayed by a friend. The next morning we see Tae-oh and Da-kyung have moved into their apartment. Da-kyung learns that Bong-ku is the only investor Tae-oh has. Tae-oh then gets delivered a suitcase with signed divorce papers. Da-kyung overhears Tae-oh making a call to Sun-woo, saying he would not agree to give up all the money in Jun-young. Sun-woo also tells him that she will charge him for embezzlement, since he transferred all the profit from his company into a slush fund. Tae-oh angrily tears the document once Sun-woo hangs up the call. Da-kyung wonders how Sun-woo learns their address in the first place. In-gyu goes looking for Hyun-seo in her workplace. So her colleague tells him that she resigned a few days ago. In-gyu makes an angry call to Sun-woo demanding to know where Hyun-seo is. He then asks her why she's not sending him the money, so Sun-woo tells him to go ahead and report what he has, and he would report him for assault and blackmailing. When Sun-woo gets to the hospital, she notices everyone eyeing her. So Myung-suk informs her about the post on the hospital webpage complaining about Sun-woo. The spread has become out of control since it is being shared on social media and other websites as well. Sun-woo acts calm in front of Myung-suk, but informs her attorney about it. The attorney informs her that it is possible Tae-oh wrote the post, since he didn't want to lose Jun-young's custody. Defaming her would be a good way to gain custody. Tae-oh leaves to find new investors and change the divorce agreement. Da-kyung urges him that she will try to convince her father to invest in his company. For that, she demands him to divorce Sun-woo as quickly as possible. When he refuses to go through the divorce as to Sun-woo's demands, Da-kyung asks him why he can't give up Jun-young's custody and think about their child. The two get interrupted by In-gyu, who is looking for Hyun-seo. When Tae-oh lashes out at In-gyu for harassing Da-kyung, In-gyu confesses to him that Sun-woo used Hyun-seo to spy on him. When Jae-hyuk got home, Yeom informs him that she would not get a divorce, since she doesn't have a job or children. So in return for not getting a divorce, she wants him to cooperate so they can have children. But Jae-hyuk agrees to stop seeing other women and refuses to have children. At the hospital, Sun-woo learns that all the patients who made appointments with her have cancelled them because of the post. Instead, Dong-sik waits for her. When the nurse hesitates to send him to her, Sun-woo tells them to do so if he has come to get treated. On hearing it, Yoon-ki offers to stay by her. Dong-sik apologizes for what happened the other day and thanks her for not pressing charges against him. He tells her that he has decided to take her advice and receive psychiatric treatment. Sun-woo gets called by Ji-chul to his room. When she gets there, she finds In-gyu and Tae-oh with Ji-chul. In-gyu leaves the room as Sun-woo enters. Ji-chul confronts her about the accusations made by In-gyu. Tae-oh mockingly brings up the online post sharing about Sun-woo when she struggles to reason with Ji-chul. Tae-oh then argues that he can't trust Jun-young with Sun-woo, since she is acting crazy. Yoon-ki on the other hand watches the entire scenario standing by the door. Tae-oh further brings up Sun-woo's parents' accident, and how she assumes her mother caused the accident on purpose, which ultimately killed both her and her husband. Tae-oh worries that Sun-woo might turn out like her mother, so leaving Jun-young with Sun-woo would be dangerous. Hurtfully, Sun-woo slaps him across the face. So Tae-oh requests a psychiatric evaluation of Sun-woo. Sun-woo quickly leaves the room without saying where she is going. Tae-oh sees Sun-woo driving off, and because he couldn't stop her, Tae-oh goes after her. He managed to catch up to her in the traffic, and demands to know what she is about to do. When Tae-oh tries to get off from the vehicle, Sun-woo drives at Tae-oh's door, and drives past leaving him in shock. Sun-woo goes to Jun-young's school and picks him up, and drives on a restricted road. So when Tae-oh gets there, the teacher informs him that Jun-young already left with Sun-woo. Tae-ho tracks Jun-young's phone and follows after them. Sun-woo turns off Jun-young's phone so Tae-oh can track them, so Tae-oh only manages to follow them to the restricted road. When Jun-young demands back the phone, Sun-woo throws it out of the car. So Jun-young gets agitated and demands to know where Sun-woo is taking him. He then makes a call from Sun-woo's phone to Tae-oh asking for help. While Sun-woo tries to get back the phone, they almost get into an accident. Sun-woo takes the phone from Jun-young, who is in shock because of the near accident, and hangs up the call as Tae-oh calls out for Jun-young. Unable to decide what to do, Tae-oh reports to the police that his son is missing. The police get reluctant to search for him when they hear that Jun-young was taken by his mother, but because of Tae-oh's demands, they agree to search for him. Sun-woo drives to the end of the road and reaches a cliff. Sun-woo decides to explain to Jun-young about Tae-oh, but Jun-young argues that Tae-oh betrayed Sun-woo by having an affair, and not him. So she tells him about Da-kyung's pregnancy, and Tae-oh has chosen to live with her. Jun-young also tells her that he doesn't want to live just with her, and begs her not to get a divorce. Shocked by it, Sun-woo demands Jun-young to agree to live with her. The police manage to find Jun-young's phone and hand it over to Tae-oh. They advise him to wait for them at home because it's his mother who took Jun-young after all. Tae-oh also gets a call from Sun-woo asking him to come home, since she wants to talk to him. When he gets home, Tae-oh demands to know where Jun-young is. In response, Sun-woo just tells him that he shouldn't have brought up her mother, and she can do anything to make him suffer. She makes him believe that she killed Jun-young. Tae-oh tries to strangle her, but because he can't do it, he pushes her off. Sun-woo knocks herself and gets injured. As Tae-oh breaks down, Jun-young walks into Tae-oh's surprise and sees injured Sun-woo. When Tae-oh tries to explain to him, Jun-young cuts in and tells him that he is not his son anymore. Yeo-rim also comes into the house and attends to Sun-woo. Later, Sun-woo's attorney informs her that Tae-oh has agreed to all her terms in the divorce agreement, and they finalize their divorce, and even manage to get a restraining order against Tae-oh for 2 years. Later, Bong-koo comes to Sun-woo and apologizes, admitting that it was Hae-jung who wrote the online post about Sun-woo, because she was angry. Da-kyung notices people lying and whispering about her destroying a family. When she tries to pay for her groceries, she learns that her credit card has been cancelled. Da-kyung goes to Bong-koo to reason with him. She also tries to convince him to help Tae-oh, but Bong-koo demands her to leave Tae-oh, and he would take care of Da-kyung and her child, or else he would pretend he doesn't have a daughter. Tearfully, Da-kyung tells him that she loves Tae-oh and leaves the house. Hyun-seo meets with Sun-woo and informs her that she reported In-Gyu for assault. She thanks Sun-woo for helping her, and confessed to her that she is the only person who helped her when she was getting beaten up by In-Gyu. At the hospital, Sun-woo learns from Myung-suk that Tae-oh is moving to a different city. 2 years pass by and Sun-woo lives a peaceful life with Jun-young. Yeo-rim and Jae-hyuk also seem to be on good terms. Jae-hyuk notices an invitation card, and as he checks, Yeo-rim tells him that she won't attend the event. When Sun-woo gets home, she too finds an invitation card mailed. Apparently, it's an invitation for Jun-young inviting him to Jenny's house party, who is Tae-oh's and Da-kyung's daughter. We then see Tae-oh returning to their city, and with that the episode ends. Thank you so much for stopping by. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you again next time.